We've all been there, right? We have this great idea for a game design or a feature, but then we try to communicate it to someone and it kind of comes out as a bit of a jumbled mess. You know, one of the biggest challenges that we face as game designers is clear communication. So today I want to talk about some tools that I've used over the years to better communicate my ideas and how they will absolutely help you to be a better game designer. If you're looking for a way to level up your collaboration and communication skills, there are a few better tools out there than Miro. It's sort of this online whiteboard, but it's also so much more. You can do brainstorming with it, with its sticky notes, but I've also used it for mind mapping and all the way up to full designs for features. This has become my new way of writing design docs, to be honest. I like it because it's really visual, and I found a lot of people don't actually read text anymore, unfortunately. But if you can convey your idea visually, you can bring them on board with it sooner. SketchUp is a 3D modeling program that was originally intended for architecture or interior design. It's relatively fast and simple extrusion method of creating objects make it pretty amazing for doing rough-ins for levels or even game mock-ups. I used this at Netflix to help some people visualize some ideas that I had for, you know, mini games that I was building. We also used this on Space Marine to visualize areas and combat scenes. And I even used it at Phoenix Labs to build out whole prototype levels really quickly. And then we just imported them to Unreal and we could use them straight away. It's never going to replace Blender as a fully, you know, 3D modeling program. It's just not fully featured enough, but it's very rapid. And that's why I like using it. Don't get me wrong, Google Slides is amazing for conveying ideas and communication, but if you need to take those, you know, presentations just one step further, check out Prezi. This is a presentation software that adds motion, zoom, and interactive elements to the overall slide deck. I've personally found it to be great for dynamically representing elements like the design of a world, say more narrative-focused things. For example, if you're building a new fantasy IP, you could have the map of the world laid out with major cities and families as interactive objects that you zoom in on when they're clicked on. This level of interactivity takes the audience's engagement to a much higher level. It means they're more likely to retain that information. This one is really complicated, but if you're willing to invest the time, it can be a big payoff. Machinations.io is pretty wild. It's a dedicated tool that allows you to model and simulate your whole game if you want to. You know, you could fully simulate your macro economy or your player's progression. If you're extremely data-driven and of that mindset, I highly recommend you take a look at this tool. Unsurprisingly, RPGMaker is a game that allows you to make RPG games. You could actually use this to make a full-blown game, of course, but I've found it useful for experimenting or exploring new ideas. It's quite solid for just implementing and trying out, say, map design or level design. Say if you were building something like Genshin Impact and didn't want to go all the way to 3D modeling straight away. You could, fairly quickly, create a 2D mock-up of the world. This would be something you could actually walk around in, get a sense of the scale, without having to build out the full thing. One of the best things about it is that it comes with a pretty decent array of assets built into it. So you don't need to spend a ton of time hunting around for packages or asset packs when you should just be prototyping and building something. These next two are a little on the controversial side, but I'd be remiss if I just pretended like they didn't exist. So there are many tools out there, but the ones that I've used the most, like many of you, are ChatGPT and Midjourney. From my personal experience working with both artists and Midjourney, anyone who thinks they can replace an artist with the tool is not thinking about it correctly. It's just not good enough. It doesn't have the same pure expression that a human artist can bring to the equation. Think about this kind of like a really customizable Google image search when you're looking for inspiration. It's great for concept art, but the reality is you shouldn't be using this for actual images or art assets in your game. On top of that, the other one that I use fairly regularly is ChatGPT. I personally leverage this as kind of like a second brain that I can bounce ideas off of, and then it unlocks new thoughts or ideas for me. In my experience using it, I've never encountered a response that I thought would be a proper design document, not even close. That said, it is a pretty big accelerator for when you're just trying to generate raw ideas that might inspire you to do something, try something new. Of course, communication tools are only useful if you have great ideas to communicate. If you'd like to learn more about that, check out this video where I get into more detail about three methods for developing better ideas. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you all later.